Taurus, to your mid-month reading for May. Hope your friends are doing great out there. If your friends like this, please like and subscribe. Okay, let's go. All my bulls, let's see what's going on in the pasture over here. And for those of you who are new, I am Taurus, and I'm also Leo rising. So, okay, let's see what's going on, my friends. And happy birthday to all you Tauruses out there. I already had mine on the 10th, so let's see what's going on. Best message, please, for the beautiful Taurus. Beautiful Taurus, beautiful Taurus. What do you have coming in, my friend? Whoa, blossom. That just fell right out. That is judgment. As if we haven't seen that card a lot within the last, within the whole year. Especially within the last couple of months, I think it's been very big within the readings, if I remember right. Do so many readings, but judgment. Beautiful blossoming of the judgment, making the judgment call, having judgment make its call for your karmic reasons. Beautiful karma coming through. These are going to be for karmic rewards. It is upright. It's saying you deserve what you deserve, Taurus. And I have karma coming in, and your life is about to blossom and bloom. Well-deserved reward. What did I just say? Hello, standing up there. Whether it's financial, love, it could be all of the above, any of the above. But this is definitely the ending, right, to whatever struggle you were looking for, the ending to, you know, whatever, right? Because where you have the ending, you have the new beginning. Wow. Nine of Pentacles. Love it, right? Well-deserved reward. Share the love. Three of Cups. Time to share the love and celebrate because you have the well-deserved reward coming in. It feels like to me, if this is a love situation, somebody sees you are a reward. I just got to say it. I got to say it, Taurus. They see you're the reward and they want to share that love with you. Chariot moving toward you. Moving towards that love. Moving towards exactly what you love. Knowing what you're worth. Whoever this person is, they know what you're worth and they want to share the love with you. And they're really moving towards you. It's kind of funny because I do feel it's a kind of a, even though it's a chariot, it's like it's going, it's going, it's going. It just makes me feel like it's slow. But they do see your worth, Taurus. And this is a gift from the universe. Yeah, yeah. Knight of Pentacles. Like I said, I'm just going to put it there because we were just talking about that. Knight of Pentacles. They are moving slowly towards you because they do see your worth. They want to be a part of that and they want to share that love with you. Well-deserved reward. Clarify on that, please. The Fool, wanting a new beginning, where I said the end becomes a new, beautiful beginning. Somebody wants to take the leap of faith with you, but they're moving very slow towards you. But they definitely want to share the love with you, Taurus. They do see you as a reward, Two of Cups, soulmate energy coming through. They do recognize you. Woo, but they're in the Nine of Wands. Ouch. Oh, that's why they're moving. They're in the Nine of Wands. Wow. So with the Knight of Pentacles, we have the Temperance. So they feel like they're going to move toward you as the Chariot. They know that you're the right path for them, the right person for them. They want to make this effort toward you, but they are the Wounded Warrior. Aww. Could be Leo, Sagittarius, or Aries. They do see you as the Two of Cups, though. They do see you as the right person for them. But they're waiting for the divine timing, so you could say that this is a moderate move. They're taking it slow. They're testing the waters. And this is because they don't want to get hurt. Totally feel it with the Nine of Wands. But they do know that they're on the right path towards you. Oh my God, this is going to turn out to be one of those beautiful readings, isn't it? Herald the wands with the Wheel of Fortune holding. They know this is a divine connection. They don't know exactly. I feel like the passion that they have for you with the Herald of the Wands. Oh, and Taurus, this is a new deck I got for Mother's Day. Shit, I forgot to tell you. I've been telling everyone. I forgot to tell my own people. Hold on, I'll show you what it is. It's really awesome. My son got these. Look at those. I got another deck too. I'll show you guys later when we use those. But yeah, he always wants to get things that, you know, nobody really sees. He's very smart. But anyways, this one is Herald the Wands. This is where they're engulfed in that flame around them of passion. They feel this passion for you, but they understand that something is going on, and they can't. At first, I don't think that they knew. But the Wheel of Fortune is over, and they really do feel that there's some kind of destiny or something is going on. I don't know if they really know, guys, that it's really a fated relationship, right? It's inevitable, fated. This is where your destiny is really going. But I do feel like they do know. Something keeps them wanting to be around you. They can't stop thinking about you. They really do feel this passionate pull towards you, but I don't know if they really believe that you're their soulmate. You understand what I'm trying to say? Some of you, you might know that. Maybe they've told you that. For the majority of you, you know, they feel this strong pull and connection towards you. But remember, they're also the wounded warrior. So, you know, they've got their own challenges that they're trying to overcome. They need healing. But they're... do you have this passion that they just cannot stop testing the water over here? So it's like they're patiently waiting for the go time. It's almost like they're waiting for the heaven's gates to open up to say, go now, which is crazy because they already have it because they have the chariot. But they're using the chariot to say, I am on the right path. Something is going on over here, but I'm not going to let it move fast. I'm going to slow that chariot down, pull it back on the reins. But I have to stay around this person. There's something that's driving me crazy about them. Taurus is driving me nuts. I can't sleep. I can't. You're in my dreams. Something is going on. And it's because of the Wheel of Fortune. So maybe they are even kind of waking up, understanding for some of them, you know what? Maybe this is destined. Maybe I am supposed to be with this person. I don't know, right? Wow. How beautiful. But they do definitely see you as a divine connection. And just saying you are the soulmate. But they cannot. Oh, my right ear's ringing. There it goes. They cannot stay away from you. You have lit the passion around them as a herald of the wands. That's I am engulfed in your passion. I am engulfed in you, Taurus. I can't stay away from you. Yeah, feeling like they have lost control. I don't know. It's really talking about them more all of a sudden than you. They have lost control of their own thoughts. Like they are engulfed within you. It's so crazy. It like went from you and then it literally turned into them. They feel like they've lost all control. They can't keep their mind. Even. Not only engulf the flame around them with passion, but they can't stop thinking about you. It's almost like every time I think of you, all I see is your eyes in my mind. Soulmate connection. If they haven't figured it out, they will. Strengthening the bond. Yeah, all they want to do right now is strengthen this bond. They really want to get to know you. They really want to know who you are, what you're about. I want to strengthen this bond because I want to know why you're in my energy so much. I want to know who are you. It's definitely something you've never dated before. And they're watching you. Wow, are they watching you? Observing you. Really paying attention to you. Focus. That's why they have no control because they just feel like, oh my gosh, I've just kind of like lost all the control over here. Every time I think about you, I lay down, I close my eyes, your eyes are there. You're there. But it's almost like they can't understand why. That's because of the soulmate connection, because the souls are through the eyes, which is their, your soul is trying to tell their soul, this is, I know exactly what this is. I think we just talked about this. We just talked about this, my friends. Seven of Pentacles, they can't stop investing energy and time with you. Now all they want to do is plan days with you to strengthen the bonds. They want to plan on strengthening everything. But because they are the wounded warrior, they still have the Seven of Swords. They're not sure how this is going to work. They're not sure if they really want this love. They're not sure what they really, really want. They're scared. There's a fear. That's a fear. Fear of loving again. But yet I can't get you out of my mind, Taurus. And I want to know everything about you. Ace of Wands, strengthening the bonds. There's a flame that is just burning within them for this new opportunity with you. Eight of Wands, that's a hot card. Well, Eight of Wands, right? Having the new ideas, right? Of excitement, bliss. They may even be having ecstasy. Could be dirty. I'm sorry, I have to say it, guys. You know, they might be having dirty dreams about you. Fantasy. This is a card of fantasy, ecstasy, nirvana, pleasure, euphoria, bliss, excitement. You get them excited. They may even be dreaming naughty things about you, Taurus. Wow. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay. I'm dreaming naughty things about Taurus. You are my fantasy. Ooh, that's hot. Oh, they're already engulfed over here. Remember, you're already engulfed over here with the flame of passion for you. Trying to figure out why the hell, why have you, what have you done to me, Taurus? That's what I keep hearing. Like, what did you do to me? You put your love spell on me. It wasn't that. It's just my soul calling your soul in. It's not my fault. Hey, when the soul wants what the soul wants, it's going to go get what that soul wants. And it got you. You put a spell on me. Nah, my soul did, not me personally. For some of you, I think it's that one reading. Didn't we do a reading not too long ago, Taurus? Those of you who have been subscribed, who watch all the time. If you remember, write it down in the comments, because I did it somewhere, but I thought it was a Taurus reading. Was, I don't even know who the hell you are. You just came out of nowhere. So how could I put a spell on you? I manifested someone to love or something. I can't remember whose reading that was. I thought it was you. So how would I put a spell on you if I don't even know where the hell you came from? You just popped into my life and I was like, whoa, thank you, universe, for love, right? Because I do remember in like, what was it, February or March or something, you guys have manifested love. You were waiting for the Nine of Cups. So how in the world could you say I put a spell on you and I don't even know who you are? And if it wasn't our reading, just remind me that it wasn't us, it was somebody else. I just remember that, because if it wasn't you, then it had to have been like Libra or Leo or something. It could have been Leo or Libra, but that kind of reminds me of that, though. Reminds me of the same thing. Like, I just met you. I don't know what you're talking about. Damn, you're hot. And yes, I want my reward. Thank you, judgment. But that's so funny. Okay, so anyway, they're observing you with the Two of Pentacles. They're really thinking. Thinking. Juggling the thoughts as they're observing the situation, as they're, you know, you got your strengthening bonds, so all their, you got their wheels moving. That's really all that is. It's got your wheels moving. You got their wheels moving. Thinking about the situation, thinking about you, Taurus. Thinking about how they're going to get towards you. How am I going to juggle this? You know. Got their wheels going. Imprints. They see you as the imprints. Well, yeah, Taurus. Male or female, it don't matter. Right? Like, you better think of me as the imprints. I do so much hard work. Nine of Cups, they do see you as wish fulfilled. They see you as this beautiful, nurturing, majestic, beautiful imprint who's got their wheels going. They're fantasizing about you. They're probably even over here thinking, now how in the hell, why am I even fan? Now how am I having dreams and fantasies of you? Right? That's what I'm saying. You have control over me, Taurus. I don't even feel like I'm in control anymore of my emotions. You have control of my dreams. You have control of my thoughts. You can't get out of my head. You got my feelings going crazy over here. You have me engulfed in your passion. I know you're my one, but I can't figure out why. And I need healing from my last relationship because I am a wounded warrior, but I don't know what I'm supposed to do. The moon. Intuitively, they know you're their nine of cups. Now, they haven't said anything, and they're playing kind of, yeah, they're kind of playing a game. Kind of like, yeah, you know. Trying to play the friend mode. Now, there's more than just the friend mode going on. Yeah. They are in denial, and that's because they're in the nine of wands. Because they don't want to move fast. Because remember, they're also in the seven of swords, right? Kind of like that mind thieving my own energy, self-sabotaging my own thoughts and feelings. Even though I know deep down inside I can't stop thinking about Taurus, but I'm going to pretend like I don't because I'm wounded over here. Wow. Okay. Well, that's what happens though when people need healing. But this is the judgment call. Like God says, this is it. Ready or not, here I come. So they can sit over here and pretend all they want, but we know what's going on. And so if they had you, if they had you in this area where you don't know if they're coming in hot, if they're coming in cold, if they're coming, where are you coming from because of the temperance, this moderate moving, remember, the moderate moving is only what they're allowing you to see, Taurus. So if you're thinking, man, and I really wanted this person to be hot and cool over me, and I really want a great relationship, but they're coming in so slow. Conversations are a little boring. They're hot and cold, and it's moderate. And, but I really want them to, dude, they do. They're hiding it so that they won't get hurt. Opportunity beckons with the challenging times. For finding balance, they need to find the balance within themselves to be able to do so. So with the opportunity beckons, oh my God, here we go again. This is the third reading now that I have had the same ending. I swear I'm not going to do you guys together in a row with the love at the bottom. Overall outcome is the love, take the lead, and believe and succeed. Okay, this is insanity, but maybe it's my own fault. Okay, Spirit, look, I always ask guys, Spirit, tell me the signs that I'm going to do. I shuffle, they all pop out, and then I put them in a row. Okay, that's fine. We'll just keep the energy flowing and going. Maybe that's what you wanted. Okay, guys, if you're dealing with the Leo, go watch the Leo reading because this is the same cards that are in the Leo reading. If you're dealing with a Leo Virgo, please go watch Leo Virgo because they have the same exact reading. Okay, that's it, right? Not even a joke. I have done, let's see, Leo Virgo, Taurus Gemini, and now you Taurus, and you all end up with the same reading at the end. This is insane. You're all sharing the same energy. It is what it is. This is amazing. I haven't had a reading like this for at least 2 years where everybody's sharing the same energy. So if you're dealing with a Leo, please go watch that. Leo Virgo cusp, watch that. If you're a Taurus Gemini and you're not watching your cusp reading, go watch your cusp reading. Because it's all saying the same exact story. It's just all made a little bit different. But yet it's all the same. Amazing. Spirit's on... just going on crazy right now. Okay, so opportunity beckons. Yeah, this is where it started on the Leo. It actually literally started with the first card on Leo. They're in the Four of Cups. They can't see behind them. Why? Because they're too busy looking at their old. I'm telling you, they were in an old relationship. They had to walk. Their relationship broke apart. They no longer have that relationship. So now they can't see behind them to see the Ace of Cups, to see that you're the Ace of Cups, because they're too busy being the Wounded Warrior and thinking about all the other cups in the past of all the things that they had, right? Which leaves them in this Five of Swords. Okay? So at the end of the month, right? So what it's really saying is that the reason that they're not coming towards you, here's the point, right? This is what you're saying, right? Because and it's funny, I just freaking said that. You're saying, if they're so hot and heavy about me, how come they're not saying anything to me? Why are they coming in so, you know, so moderate? So like testing the waters with me because of the Nine of Swords and because of the opportunity beckons. Now, this is crazy, though, in some ways. It's a little bit different because now I can kind of see, like, they know you're the Ace of Cups, and that's the way it started. That is exactly the way that Leo started. They know you're the Ace of Cups, but they're too afraid to turn around and let you know you're their true love. Aha! And the more I keep doing this reading, it's all coming together, and it's like a little story. And it just keeps getting deeper and deeper. And I'm getting, I like totally understand this whole relationship now. I'm like, oh my God, I've done it like 4 times now. And I'm getting all these different pieces and parts of the story. Wow, this is like, it makes me want to just erase everything on everybody and just say the greatest love story ever, the greatest love story ever. Just literally. Five of Swords. Because they keep themselves in the Five of Swords, so they can't really give all of this to you, but yet they know you're the Ace of Cups, but there has to be a Tower. Oh, but you know what? That's not going to happen because the Tower's on the challenging time. Oh, it's the same as the other one. Their Tower is going to happen. As soon as they realize and that they want to come towards you, and once they actually do come towards you, it's going to cause a freaking Tower. Now, in some of the other ones, I do want to bring this up, and this is for some of you and not all of you. In some of these situations, there is a, how do we say that? It's a third party situation, but it's not a third party situation. It's actually a fourth party situation. Okay? And this is because you're getting out of a relationship, they're getting out of a relationship, and that's when the judgment calls in the two soulmates and brings the two together, but yet you guys need to separate from the other two, right? They just had something happen to where either they need to 100% get out of their relationship or they had just walked away from their relationship. I'm not sure if they're going to go back, something like that, and vice versa, the same with you, right? Or it's just the third party, right? Three of Cups. Okay. And that doesn't surprise me because I keep getting four of cups, right? Fourth party situation. Something like that. That's for some of you, not all of you. But if you know that that's a situation, that's what's going on. But with the Tower over here, the Tower is saying, this is all going to crumble down. As soon as the awareness comes in and he or she decides to turn around, realize that you're the Ace. Well, look, they already know you're the Ace of Cups. They realize they want to actually extend that piece of love and quit messing around over here. That's when the Tower comes. Okay, so there is challenging times going on within this person and maybe even yourself. So you both could be going through challenging times, but that's when the Six of Swords comes. That's when they say, okay, I'm going to turn around. I see you. I have Five of Swords. I'm going to battle my way out of this. I'm going to come for my cup of love. That's going to cause a Tower within their relationship, your relationship, however, whatever. But it's the full awareness of I have to have Taurus. It's going to cause some kind of competition. They may feel like there's competition. No matter what it is, it's some kind of challenge. It could even be an internal battle that they have to where they're like, you know what? I have to have this. I can't do this no more. I have to have Taurus. This is when they start moving towards you. This is when they come. This is when they get on their boat. It could be from a long ways away. They might even get on an airplane. Who knows? Okay, but they're coming to get you. That's it. I'm done. I'm not doing this anymore. And this is as soon as they realize that they're done with the Ten of Wands. They're done with the Ten of Wands. They're coming out of hermit mode because they've been in hermit mode. They've seen the light. They understand what's happening, and they're ready to rock and roll. You know what? I'm coming for you, Taurus. I've thought about it. Two of Wands. I thought about it. I looked out, and I'm saying, you know what? This is, you're who I want. This is going to change the whole world. This is the cycle change I want. I don't want this anymore. I'm tired of being sad. I'm tired of walking around on a stick. I want this new world with you. Finding the balance. This is where they're going to find the balance, finally. Two of Pentacles, finding the balance. Harold, oh, yeah. Yeah, because now they feel it, and they know they're going to have to self-sacrifice something, but they've thought about it enough. See the crows up here? They're taking that transition. They're going to let go of what they need. They're going to jump down, stop hanging around. They know what they want now, and this is going to cause the balance. Oh, my God, this is so beautiful. Clarify, on the Hangman, Four of Wands, escaping. Yes. Escaping all the hurt, all the things that they don't want anymore. I'm escaping. That's it. I'm done. I'm done with this energy. I'm done with this. I want Taurus. I gotta go. Yep. Yep. Oh my gosh. Escaping the mind, escaping this old relationship, escaping whatever the hell it is, right? We're the Queen of Pentacles. Bam. Whatever, got the love over here. So the love is of the Queen of Pentacles, earth sign energy. Even though it's a Capricorn card, we don't care, right? We're going to take it because they're saying, this is where my heart is. They see you as nurturing. They see you as the Queen of Pentacles. They see that you're caring, loving, great mother, great family person. And that's what they want. And they have love for you, Taurus. And I'm going after my Taurus. Three of Pentacles. They want to collaborate. They want to grow. They want to build something with you. They don't want to build with this other person. If they had another person, they're not going back to them. And like I said, if that's what was going on, go watch that Leo reading, because that was what it was talking about, was that they could be trying to figure out whether or not they need to go back to where they came from or start a new relationship or just stay by themselves. Right. Okay. But you got the Three of Pentacles. They're saying, I want to collaborate with you. I want to be with you. I want to start something and build a life and a love relationship with you, Taurus. Taking the lead. Oh my gosh. Three of Wands. Taking the lead. Having the progress. They want to have this progress. They want to build. Oh my God, this is beautiful. They see the Ten of Cups with you. They realize that, you know, and you know what, Taurus, I think this is you. Judgment is coming in, and there's the judgment call. I'm just keeping it there, because what the believe and the succeed is saying, you know what, this, oh my God, on the bottom is the sun. You gotta be kidding. Oh, okay. Let's just put that there for a minute. Blessing from the universe. Okay, the gift, the blessing, the overall. With the believe in the succeed, Taurus, is really what I believe these cards are yours, because I really do believe. But I do believe that you guys actually share this energy. Because I do believe, no matter what, the two souls called each other in. And because you both needed the love and you're ready to have this deep connection. So I do believe, with the believe in the succeed, the Six of Wands, the overall victory, is the Magician of the Hierophant. And I do 100% believe that you both manifested a true love relationship that was going to be victorious. I'm tired of this crap. I need real love, God. Judgment has been called. Judgment has been made. And the blessing is coming in. They may not want to see it. That's the way it is. And you have the Ace of Cups, which is exactly the same card that was in the last reading too. And in fact, you watch the Leo and the Leo Virgo, the Ace of Cups is the overall kind of message too. Why this is happening is the what? The gift of the love from the universe. The gift. The karmic gift. You had the growth. You wanted the love. You called it in. Your souls called each other in because of the concern. You were concerned that you would maybe never call, you know, have love. Look at that 33. Look at the synchronized. There we go. Synchronized numbers coming out. Look at that. You got the 20. You got the 30. You have the 22 coming out with the official person, right? Because all you want is the family room, a place where you can love and feel respected. You have the lovers coming out. A place where you feel like true love exists. A place where you feel like, you know what, this is where the true love really is. And I'm calling this in. And I do believe the majority of you, your soul called this person in because all you guys do is manifest each other over and over and over again. And I'm going to tell you right now, if for those of you who said I never manifested any of this, then that's because your soul knew that no matter what, you were ready for a true love. No more messing around with all these other people. No more messing around with all this crap, right? We're waiting for the perfect timing to come in. Because no matter what, right, I still believe you called them in. And I know that because I've done this reading many, many times. And it just seems like we're waiting and waiting and waiting for all of this to actually go kaboom. It's like we're waiting for it to blow up. And when it does blow up, boy, is it going to blow up. So let control of, you know, let go of control issues. Let them come and let them understand what they need. You guys just keep giving them love. They, you know, they need to make the effort. They need to make the effort in understanding, right, what it is that needs to happen, right? Because they're a little lost within their thoughts. Yeah, because they need to release their ex. They're not sure what the hell they're doing. Right? They're not sure. They're a little confused. And look, guys, if they don't watch tarot and learn the way we learn, that is going to be very confusing because it's not like they're going to be like, oh, yeah, I totally get it. You know, they don't watch this. Yep, there it is, calling in a soulmate. Thank you for playfulness. But there has to be a separation, right? But they have to come to the love and understanding, to love themselves first, to make themselves understand that they deserve this. That this is a judgment call from the universe. But that's where they're going to have to look behind them and say, you know what? Something friggin' weird is going on. And they're going to see it because no matter what, the universe is going to make them see it. With the tower. The sudden wake up. The sudden there's something weird going on. Maybe they'll start seeing 333444. I never noticed it before. Right? And something weird is happening. Something, I don't understand what's going on. Why are you in my dreams? Why are you here? Why are you there? How come I can't stop? You know what I mean? Why are you driving me crazy? Why do I love you? Yeah, why do I love you so much? I don't even really know you. Well, my soul knows you. And that's what's going to be crazy though, Taurus, is because you're just going to take it all calm. Like, but my soul knows you. And I have a deep feeling for you. And you drive me crazy too. And I can only imagine... they drive you crazy as well. Okay, guys. Till next time, Taurus. Bye-bye.